What happened actually before was that a brother was sitting on one of the bank teller things, two of them, and the cops were sort of surrounding them and looked like they were about to hassle them. And everyone is sort of in some reaching consensus meeting or something. And so we had to get their attention, to get everyone's attention around to protect those people. Because there was about 10 cops and they were choosing these two. Whenever you isolate, right, it's numbers. And so if you can get everyone together, it's a different ballgame, because it's not whatever, they're going to choose whatever they choose. But whatever they choose is generally they're looking for, you know, numbers. And if they don't got the numbers, they're not going to do it. So to protect ourselves, we need numbers. And we need way more numbers than we have right now. This isn't growing fast enough. And so the people that are sitting on the fence, the people that have ever been an activist, the people that care about some sort of larger issue, the people that want to protect Mother Earth, the people that look at the geopolitical situation, banking system, and political decisions and say, we're tired of it. If you agree with what I just said or feel part of that, it's a united front of people to stand up to this oppression, to stand up to defending BC, whatever we call that, from being completely taken over by either North American banking interests or the global cabal or whatever it is. And we have to acknowledge the First Nations title. We have to really understand what the residential school system was about, what happened and how to heal it with true healing lodges in a way that, you know, that is run by the First Nations people in their way. And if we don't go to that foundation, the true title of land, the real jurisdiction, we're not going to win. But if we do, we can't lose. And the police at some point can do, they will not be able to do anything. And when we realize that, that's our own empowerment. And when we share it together, and aimed at good objectives, you're going to see some massive change coming from all these people down here, through them, and to you, who's ever watching this. Because this is the message to you to come on down, to see what this is. It's not just about bank protests, it's about empowerment through connection with other people who think the same, so you can begin to understand why this world is the way it is, and how we can change it. I want you to come with us. And I want to show you something. You see, right here is Canada Trust, which in some people's minds may be an oxymoron of trust and Canada coming together. We've been lied to in so many ways that we don't know who to trust, and certainly the people we are trusting less and less are the major banks of Canada. And they participate in a global banking system, which after Bretton Woods in 1944 created the IMF and the World Bank. And since then, there's this incredible economic system that is ruled by debt and ruled by these banks. And basically, there's no real work done. They just kind of skim it off the top from everybody. And so now, for the first time in my life, and I don't know anywhere maybe where it's occurred, where all across the planet, all the people who all our lives have been going, feeling alone, seeing what's going on and going, I don't want to participate in this, now standing up together and claiming space. This is community space. This is First Nations space. Whose space is it? Who has jurisdiction? So we went into the bank. But we went into the bank. So, in here was like 60, 70 kids and people, and they're just like, yeah. And they're dancing. The music's on, there's people in the background, it's like a Canadian bank. I've never seen this, you know? They took over the bank. And then the cops came in, the people went out, and there was talk about consensus, and there was talk about what are we doing here. There's people who wanted to party, and there's people who didn't want to party. And I was getting a bit bored. Not bored, but kind of like, there's different ways to do things. So I took out my, I got this prototype of a game, a communication game. And it sits 12 people together. And so this game has three things. It has a conversation field, intention, and attention. And what it's looking at is conscious communication. It's looking at using tools to help us to get outside of the normal thinking patterns and to see the world in a new way. So, we wanted to introduce a new course, experiential learning course, in the bank, a how to talk to police officers in high emergency situations. So, we're sitting, 12 people over there, at the back of the bank over there, we're sitting there, around this, about to start a workshop. And there's a line of cops there, and they were lining up, and the other people were all dancing and arguing and doing stuff, right? And I whistled. I'm going like, guys, they're here, and they're changing their tactics. They'd already set up a perimeter at the door. They stop, people come in. The group doesn't know. The group is like in consensusville. I don't know what's going on. They were partying or consensus, but those are the only two strategies. How to really look at the space they're in. They took over a space. There's some power there. People are having a good time. You know, it was just like the cops just can come in and take you out. It was just like, no, we're letting these people do this. Why? Because there's a reason why. There's a reason why we're getting away with it. It's because they know there's a hidden power here. That all of us are starting to rise up, and they can't push too hard, because guess what? It's way more of us than them. And so this was a line in the sand. This was just coming in a group of people, and they came to us and they say, you have to leave now.
The police or the bank?
The police.
Okay.
A police chief, I don't know his name, very politely, very respectfully. But he's saying, it's enough. But it's on his terms. It's on the police terms. You're gonna go, like right now. We're going, well, we got to talk about it, right? We're sitting around the table. We just started this course on how to talk to police officers in high-risk areas. You just started. So this is the beginning of our course. We got to talk about what you just said because we don't know if we want to go right now. We don't know if we haven't even decided. We don't even know who each other is. We'll get back to you in a few minutes. So we started talking, and each person's talking about who they are and why they're there. And then I think he comes back in and he goes, guys, have you made up your minds yet? And we're Canadians, you know, we got to talk. People like to talk, you know, we order some coffees or something. But the police are kind of like, they're using, this is the reasoning they use. They said, the bank people have to go home. You got them in here. The other reasoning they said was, if we weren't here, we'd be out doing what we're supposed to be doing, which is policing the world. Their world. Now, there's some sort of like conflict a bit about, you know, whether that was valid, because I'm saying that's not valid. He's saying, oh, we shouldn't be protecting people, but using that as reasoning to stop a protest about banks, where we're questioning the very jurisdiction of the police force to even talk to us on this Coast Salish territory. Their jurisdiction isn't here. And when you get down to things like that, rule of law, we're in the right. They are the ones that have been living a lie. And when you really take a stand and you're firm together with other people and you're standing in the truth, at some point they cannot budge you. And that home base is a space now that's fortifying. It's like people are coming in, they're putting tents up, everyone's staying. They don't want to go. And it's not just until this happens, it's kind of like, I don't think we should go ever. It's like something's changed in the nature of how people are seeing one another and realizing that this corporate infrastructure is killing us. And you can't wait anymore. It has to happen now. And it comes truly from the United People and actually knowing and believing that they can create a different world. And that's what we're doing immediately. I've never seen a more organized anything. Within about 7 days, there's about 25 committees, and half the committees are about the other committees, talking about the process of making a committee. And everyone's hyped about this. And then they get the General Assembly for the consensus, and they're all together, you know. You know, what's amazing is the passion of the people to even do a process, right? We're not a mob. You know, these are people who facilitate. There's people who work. There's people who can do things. There's probably 1,000 people ready to work, ready to pitch in. But we're just still, it's a week. It's a week. It's nothing. But today, in this bank, was the first time, because we took over a square. Earlier, there was an intersection, and we sat down, 30 of us, we sat down, we said, stop. We're gonna tell you a bit of what we think. And then we came in here, and we're, you know, more out of control, more chaotic. We're just dancing in a bank. But what does that mean? It means that the banks have been found out. It means that we have seen you, we know who you are. We're coming in here to show you, and we're showing the world, and pretty soon you are gonna be very scared of us. Because your end is coming. Because we cannot live in this banking system anymore. It corrupts the soul of every other human being. It has to end at some point. Captain Sweep, out.